misses. Davison backs it home.
Over to Mike Bibby. He spots up for a three.
Yeah! What a big three. Indescribable from Indianapolis. The milestone victory for Arizona.
Simon Says championship.
Nobody believes it. Nobody.
The 1997 national champions, your Arizona Wildcats.
Cool Cats. Arizona's improbable march to the national championship. The Arizona Wildcats entered the 1997 NCAA tournament as decided underdogs. But after 3 weeks of championship dreams, Arizona stood atop the college basketball world, claiming its first ever NCAA championship. In defeating three number one seeds, Arizona's unprecedented tournament run brought them college basketball's top prize. For others, just playing in the tournament was reward enough, the culmination of weeks and months of hard work, a season-long quest to reach Indianapolis. The 97 tournament featured the usual twists and turns that we've come to expect from the greatest spectacle in sports.
Game, baby. One more game, stun it. goes on.
Heading to the regional.
Let's go! Let's round
it! Sweet 16!
College basketball at its best, NCAA.
Teams made travel plans for Indianapolis in search of the pot of gold. From the Midwest came the number one seed, Minnesota, making its first trip to the Final Four. Highlighting the Golden Gophers' 27-win regular season was the Big Ten championship for Coach Clem Haskins. Led by Bobby Jackson and Sam Jacobson, Minnesota came from obscurity at the start of the season to end up ranked in the top five during the last 7 weeks of the season. The East produced a second number one seed, the University of North Carolina. Led by the incredible play of Vince Carter and Antoine Jameson, Carolina and its legendary coach Dean Smith rebounded from a difficult start. The Heels had lost their first three Atlantic Coast Conference games, yet still managed to earn a record 23rd straight tournament invitation. Out of the West rode Kentucky, the third top seed to advance to the Final Four. Nick Pitino and the defending national champion depended on the play of All-America Ron Mercer to once again propel them into the NCAA tournament. The Wildcats were ranked in the top 10 all year in search of their seventh national title. Coming from the Southeast bracket was surprising Arizona. The quick young Cats were led by the outstanding backcourt of junior Miles Simon and freshman Mike Bibby. In making the tournament for the 13th straight year, Coach Lute Olson's Cats amassed 19 regular season victories.
Once the brackets came out, we felt we'd match up with any team in the country.
Arizona met South Alabama in the tournament's first round, where the Wildcats found themselves down by 10 in danger of an early exit.
I think the South Alabama game showed the tenacity of this group and the never say die.
The second round saw a second Cats comeback. This time a win over the College of Charleston and a berth into the Sweet 16.
After that game, I think we played a little relaxed, and I mean, everybody just kept on picking us to lose, and we just wanted to prove people wrong.
Arizona's next hurdle was the tournament favorite, number one, Kansas.
Everybody had them cutting down the nets already, but no, the Arizona roadblock got in the way.
Bibby, no look to Anderson for the dunk.
Great pass by Bibby.
Dickerson, tough shot. Wow. Bibby comes out with it.
In traffic.
Arizona has pulled off the biggest upset of this tournament.
After that game, that just proved, you know, to us that we could, you know, conquer any situation.
Against Providence, the Wildcats were tested again and needed overtime to defeat the Friars.
Arizona starts the celebration. They're heading to Indianapolis and the final four.
On Friday, the four teams gathered for one final practice. In less than 24 hours, they would return to the same port and begin the pursuit of a national championship.
Final four extra, half a dollar, 50 cents.
The RCA Dome in Indianapolis would serve as the stage for the 1997 College Basketball Championship, the final stop on the road to Championship 3. The first semifinal pitted Arizona against North Carolina.
Even though we're ranked number four seed and everyone else is number one, rankings really doesn't make a difference. I mean, we have a lot to lose.
Hopefully I stay mentally focused throughout and play basketball. That's the most important thing. You don't have any time to get away from the game of basketball against this Arizona team because they'll jump out on you.
Everybody's picked us to lose every game, and we've just stuck together and believed in ourselves, and that's what's gotten us to this point, and nothing's going to change when we step out on the court.
This is what college basketball, college life is all about. And if you're not out here having fun, then, you know, you should probably just go ahead and get yourself a 9-to-5 job.
Tips to Simon for a two-point basket, 3 seconds into the game.
Arizona's early enthusiasm would soon fade as Carolina kicked up its heels and quickly threatened to turn the game into a blowout.
Carter rips away the rebound. Williams ahead, and what a pass.
Got it to Carter. Now comes to Zwicker. Jump shot, top of the foul circle, good. And it's 11-4 in favor of the Tar Heels.
Time for Dickerson to get off, Jim. They've got to get him scoring.
Stolen away. 2-on-1.
Carter's a finisher.
And one. Foul on Bibby.
Cota. Now in the game, Jameson's on the bench. Here's Cota. The alley-oop. And the stop by Carter.
Big concern right now by Lute Olson. His young team, without one senior that plays, in some trouble here early.
Down 15-4 probably with some teams you'd really be worried, but this team has been the kind of team that, hey, they'll be down, they'll be up, they'll, you know, who knows what's going to happen next.
What did happen was the emergence of Mike Bibby and Miles Simon, Arizona's peerless backcourt, which helped Cats claw their way back into the game.
He just stepped up to another level that I've never seen him step up to before.
Bibby inbounds to Simon. He pumps the three. That's good. Miles Simon.
Miles just steps up at the right times. And, you know, in the first half, he took it upon himself to, you know, knock down his shots and play with that air of confidence that, you know, rubbed off on all of us.
Coming front court now is Simon for Arizona. Here's another three, and it's good. 17-14.
Good to see Miles having the confidence from outside the arc, two in a row.
Nobody else was hitting, and, you know, I just tried to take it upon myself to lift the team up.
Simon scored 8 points in 3 minutes as the Carolina lead evaporated. Zona began playing its brand of basketball.
Game a little frenetic right now. To be quite honest with you, that's what Arizona's like. Dean Smith, team is really kind of out of sync here, going for the spectacular as opposed to the solid. That's not the way they win.
Midway through the first half, both teams settled into a half-court offense. Jason Terry gave Arizona a much-needed boost, while Tar Heel Vince Carter got his in spectacular style. And when Bennett Davison had to leave the game with foul trouble, Carter and Carolina found they could gather points inside. But Arizona discovered its own interior game and kept the score close until Carter kept coming, scoring 15 in the first half.
Crossover, has the ball knocked away and stolen. Here goes Vince Carter on the run. Bibby chasing him. He'll put it up, score it, and he's fouled.
Down three with a little more than a minute left in the half. The scoreless Bibby buried a three.
High, good. 31-31. First basket of the game for Mike Bibby.
And when Miles Simon capped his 15-point half, the Wildcats had run down the lead by the break.
And Zwicker getting in foul trouble. What control of the body by Miles Simon.
And the Cats will take the lead into the locker room.
And they have the momentum.
Arizona 34 and North Carolina 31.
U-O-A. Though they led at halftime, there was no time for the young Cats to celebrate.
I asked them how they thought they had played, and to a person it was like terrible. I said, well then, you know, I mean, we played terribly and we're up three. Then let's get out and get after them and do the things that we can do.
The Cats' formula for second half success would start with their sensational freshman.
I was a little bit nervous before the game started, but that's why my shots weren't falling, I think, because I was timid and with my shot selection. And, I mean, I just came out in the second half and just let it go.
His confidence renewed, Bibby would find his game. But the same wouldn't be true for Shamon Williams, one of Carolina's leading scorers. Blanketed in the first half, Williams came out cold in the second and shot only 1 of 13 for the game.
Williams can't get an open look today.
1 of 9 from the field.
Our game plan was, hey, you've got to meet him at the three-point line. If you don't, he's gonna fire the thing before you get there.
How about Terry shadowing Williams? He just won't give him room to breathe, much less shoot.
If Shamon Williams got to a good start, we might be in some trouble. So we tried to make their inside guys beat us.
With Williams stopped outside, Carolina forced the ball inside unsuccessfully.
That'll make Antoine Jameson think twice about going up so lackadaisically the next time.
Guys start looking, you know, a little bit. Is he there? Is he going to block the shot? And that's just the type of attitude that we had. We wanted to be aggressive with them. And, you know, I thought everybody did a great job.
Led by A.J. Bramlett and Donnell Harris, the smaller, quicker Cats blocked 8 Carolina shots.
Our speed just causes problems for anybody.
Up 2 with 15 minutes remaining. It was time for Mike Bibby to jumpstart the struggling Arizona offense.
38-36. Here's Bibby, top of the foul circle, banked it off the glass. Good. Bibby had a big smile on his face when that one went through. Simon on the drive to the baseline, faking Carter, trying to get room, throws it away, recovered by Bibby. Jump shot is good. And it is 45-38.
Wildcats inbound the ball, baseline left. Bibby will leave it for Simon. Wide open for a three. Left corner is good. Back out Bibby. He puts up a three. Got it.
Oh, back-to-back trade.
53-42. Cats' biggest lead of the ball game.
Arizona now clicking on the offensive end.
I just kept on shooting, and I went back to the basics of my shooting, like I was shooting in practice.
Here's Bibby the other way. Fired, no look for Jason Terry. He'll penetrate down the lane. Back out Bibby. Three-pointer, top of the key. Good.
Oh, Arizona on the perimeter game. Dean Smith needs that 20 seconds. He's upset.
Mike Bibby is unbelievable.
Bibby again. In an incredible scoring explosion, Bibby hit 5 three-pointers on his way to scoring 17 in the second half. The freshman sensation had catapulted Arizona into the championship game.
Do you feel it yet?
I feel it. Championship game for Arizona, baby! Nobody believed it.
Nobody. And the Arizona contingent behind us, absolutely ecstatic. The Cats knock off their second number one seed in this tournament. Arizona 66, North Carolina 58. It's the Cats against either Kentucky or Minnesota on Monday night for the championship.
The second semifinal featured defending champ Kentucky and Minnesota.
Minnesota and Kentucky, they haven't met in 40 years, and they're doing it at Indianapolis in the NCAA semifinal round.
It's just a great honor just to be out there playing, and it's just something I dreamed about.
I had a dream of winning a national championship, and I did accomplish that last year, but I never dreamed of going back to back.
When you talk about this game, two evenly matched teams, I think it's going to come down to basketball basics, rebounding, the three-point shot, and turnovers.
If we press, we're going to give it everything we got because that's the type of system that we run. There's no use in changing now.
We got to really be mentally tough for 40 minutes and stay focused because they bring great pressure. They bring it 94 feet, and they give you many different looks. So I think, number one, you got to handle their pressure.
Though focused on the task, Minnesota would struggle early, trying to solve Kentucky's press.
Inside, again taken away. Minnesota without a shot on its first two possessions.
When the Cats turned up the heat, the Gophers seemed frozen for fear.
A walking violation. Jam Jacobson runs the basketball over for Minnesota, who opens a little bit nervous against Kentucky.
Four possessions, four turnovers by the Golden Gophers.
We just had to set up the press early, try to pressure them real hard, try to make them wear down. And in the first couple of minutes, we did turn them over, so I think it gave us momentum.
Patino wanted to capitalize, and with Minnesota out of sync, Anthony Epps canned the three, giving the Cats the upper hand. Not to be outdone, Ron Mercer joined the attack and provided one of the highlights of the tournament.
Here we're going to see the kind of thing that only the gifted can do.
After an array of turnovers and five Kentucky trades, the Golden Gophers found themselves down 10 and in a big hole. With the defending champions gaining momentum, the Minnesota faithful had reason for concern. But Coach Clem Haskins found a way to reel in the runaway train, going inside and outside as the Gophers chipped away at the lead.
They won't go away.
Minnesota trying to make a run to continue to cut into that Kentucky lead.
Kentucky had a 10-point lead at one time. That's cut in half at the half.
Despite 15 first-half turnovers, the Gophers were still in the game. Like Kentucky, ready to battle the final 20 minutes to reach the championship game.
That's a huge one for confidence.
Absolutely.
Epps, two-point swish. Minnesota coming out of the locker room here with a nice boost.
Last place you want to go against Kentucky is into the deep corner.
And it's going to be just an uncontested dunk.
Harris hustles into the front court to Jackson. Back to Harris. In for the fast break basket. Beautiful.
Only 3 minutes into the second half, Minnesota had pulled within one. But when Clem Haskins was hit with a technical foul, it looked like Minnesota's momentum would shift the other way. Especially with the Cats dramatically used injured star Derek Anderson to shoot the free throw.
When he caught on Derek, I believe everybody was really happy for him to even come back and have a chance to get into the game and do something like that.
When he knocked him down, I think that just
you know, gave the whole team a whole lot of momentum.
In less than a minute, Kentucky had built its lead to 8. Minnesota now needed to respond.
Let's see what the Minnesota players are made of now.
Flim Haskins settled his players, and the Gophers would not go away.
Swish!
51-45 in favor of Kentucky.
Jackson brings it to 4. 51-47 Kentucky.
Give Flim Haskins credit here. That 20-second timeout calmed himself and his team down.
Look at that pass.
And it's intercepted by Carver. Gophers ball over to Bobby Jackson. Left side, jump shot. The Gophers pick the lead. Jackson with a 3.
Midway through the second half, it was a new ball game.
We knew they weren't going away. If you follow Minnesota throughout the course of the season, they're mentally tough, they're physically tough, and they don't go away.
Neither would Ron Mercer's cramps. And just when it looked like Kentucky might be the team on the ropes, the Cats looked again to their pressure defense.
Came in to get the steal. Just like a safety in football. Quickly underneath. And it's a 4-point lead for Kentucky.
Muhammad.
Hook. Huge shot.
6 unanswered.
Kentucky goes to
Magic.
Wildcats.
Kentucky had withstood Minnesota's charge and responded with a 17-5 run of its own. The Cats would again move on, seeking a second straight national championship. This year, the road to the championship would go through America's heartland, where the colorful Midwestern farmland would lay the backdrop for the picture yet to be painted. And so we were down to 2 for the championship. Arizona and Kentucky.
40.
It'll be a fast-paced, entertaining game, I'm sure.
Arizona, if it wins tonight, would complete what will be the most amazing 11-day run in championship history.
We don't surrender. We dig in. We don't panic when the other team comes on.
And the Wildcats take the floor looking for back-to-back national championships.
It'll be a great feeling being here, especially when nobody thought we'd be here. It'll be for everybody's first national championship.
To win another national championship, and we're going to keep fighting to the end and until we get that national championship.
I hope the kids can get it done. It's a thrill to be in the championship game, but not a whole lot of people remember the second place team.
We'll get this one underway. Many of the fans on their feet, the flashbulbs go off, and Kentucky wins the tip.
Right from the start, Arizona would call on its tenacious defense to help ignite the offensive fire. And stripped away by Dickerson. Bibby in traffic scores the game's first point. Terrific. Wayne Turner put the defending champs on the scoreboard.
Turner off balance.
But Bennett Davison answered right back.
Rebound Bennett Davison, he answered to lays it in. Arizona regains the lead of 4-2. Kentucky with the basketball.
Known for its perimeter game, Kentucky would look for points from beyond the arc from senior guard Anthony Epps.
Left side of Anthony Epps fires up a 3. It's good. Kentucky takes the first lead.
And three-point specialist Scott Padgett.
3, it's good. Kentucky goes ahead by 2 at 8-6.
You love me! You love me! You love me! You love me!
On offense, Arizona turned to point guard Mike Bibby, the youngest player in the Cats starting lineup.
Here comes Arizona.
Yeah, they break early. No problem with the press. Bramlett for 2 and a free throw.
Cats again denying the open looks. Off to Simon. In transition. Left corner Dickerson. 4-3. Yes.
There we go. And he falls over Rick Pitino.
Helping Bibby drive the Arizona engine was tournament standout Miles Simon. Together, the two led Luke's Cats on an early 11-5 run as Arizona took the lead.
Back out on top to Bibby for 3. Good. Boy, if you leave him open, Bibby's going to kill you. And that's the longest lead of the game for either ball club.
It's out at 6 now for Arizona. 19-13, Arizona.
To keep its lead and any hopes of victory, Arizona needed to shut down Ron Mercer, Kentucky's leading scorer, and the key to Kentucky's offensive attack.
With Ron Mercer, you know, he is such a great player, and you can't give him looks at threes. And we tried to keep a fresh guy on him, so Michael Dickerson and Jason Terry shared that duty. But what we told him is that you cannot be screened. I don't want to hear about you got hit with three screens. I don't want to hear. You get into him, and you get over the screen and see whether you're as tough as what he is.
Olsen's team responded and held Mercer to only three first-half points. Zona smothered the All-America, leaving him frustrated, shooting only one of four from the field. It was up to others, like Cameron Mills, to pick up the slack. And the walk-on responded with seven big first-half points, giving Big Blue a desperately needed lift.
Cameron Mills brings Kentucky within one of 19-18.
And with Wayne Turner bank one in off the glass, Kentucky owned its first lead
Turner
in almost 10 minutes.
For a Whitaker bank shot, it puts Kentucky back out on top.
With the game knotted at 20 and halftime on the horizon, both coaches look for players to emerge and drive their teams to the break. For Arizona, that player was Miles Simon. He knocked down 15 in the opening half, picked up where he left off in the semifinals.
Simon has scored the last 9 points for Arizona.
Kentucky responded with Nazi Muhammad, who came off the bench to lead UK with 8 first-half points and 7 rebounds. As the first-half duel continued, Patino knew his team was in for a catfight when Arizona's Jason Terry turned up the heat.
Arizona regains the lead 31-30.
Kentucky continued to ride the inside strength of Muhammad.
Nazi goes under and stuffs the ball right into the face of Bramlin.
As the grueling first half came to a close, Kentucky hit the locker room battered and bruised. Arizona had met the early challenge. Patino had more questions than answers. And Arizona had a one-point lead.
Olsen's Arizona Wildcats leading 33-32 at halftime.
With the national championship on the line, Lute Olsen would hearken back to a familiar question he'd asked his team throughout the year. Who's the tougher team?
That was our motto. I mean, he told us at halftime we're up one and we haven't played well. And, you know, who wants it? I mean, we're 20 minutes away from the national championship. And, you know, are you guys going to go out there and play the type of basketball you've been playing, or are you going to throw it in?
We play everything on the line for this team right now, for these
20 minutes.
13 guys, man. This is what we're playing there for.
If you guys are tough, you can come home with the title.
Family, let's go, baby.
If you get tired and they're tougher than we are, then you're going to be a runner-up that not a whole lot of people will remember.
But the next 20 minutes would make this a night to remember, as both teams would rise to the challenge, and each coach would find players to create second-half magic. For Arizona, the first to step up was Mike Bibby. By now, it surprised no one when Arizona's not-so-secret weapon showed a maturity well beyond his 18 years. In leading the Zona attack. On this night, the Cats' super freshman would score 14 in the second half, as well as pull down 7 critical rebounds. But most important was the ease with which Bibby handled Kentucky's pressure defense.
Mike Bibby has a sense for the floor like, I mean, I don't know that I've ever seen anybody like it.
It doesn't matter how old I am, I mean, I have a feel for the game. I think I've been running the game for so long, and to our team, it seems like we were supposed to do what we did.
In the second half, Bibby had plenty of help from Miles Simon, who matched his first half output with 15 on his way to being named the game's most outstanding player.
So I'll try to put it on my own shoulders, and I felt, you know, that I could penetrate on Kentucky.
Miles is as tough-minded a young man as I have ever seen. We knew, and he knew, that for us to get this thing done, he had to be the motor.
38-36, Arizona back on top. The other side of the court is Simons. He leans under, throws it up on a runner. Good. Boy, he can flat play, folks. That's 19 for him. He's carrying Arizona on his shoulder for the national championship. 40-36. Arizona leads Kentucky with the ball. Mercer, double team, moves in. Ball stolen by Harris. Quickly off to Simon. Here goes Miles, driving the other way on F. Lean in shot is up, making no good. Harris with the follow for two.
Arizona again, Brian. Too quick for Kentucky.
42-36. Wildcats, and that's their biggest lead. Kentucky wants a 20-second timeout.
Gotta love the underdog.
5 minutes into the second half, the underdog looked like the favorite. But tournament-tough Kentucky was not about to roll over and let the younger Wildcats run away with the crown. Mercer, Muhammad, and Turner would spark the comeback.
Mercer left side, turns, can't shoot. Inside Muhammad, shot up and in.
Turner with it. Turner drives in the paint. Blows it up. It's good. He's fine. Basket pop.
He's missed six in a row, but tipped up and in by Mercer. Come back from six down to tie it at 44.
Tremendous will on the part of both of these teams tonight.
Stolen back by Terry. To Simon, slicing in for two.
That was a very important basket for Arizona. They were really on the ropes here.
Cats take the lead again, 46-44. Kentucky with the ball.
Mercer.
Mercer's high wire act and subsequent free throw gave Kentucky its first lead since the opening minutes of the half. And when Epps connected on a long three, UK jumped ahead by two, its biggest lead all night.
50-48.
Arizona began looking for help from the bench. Donnell Harris responded with 8 points and six rebounds.
To tie it with a jam.
Harris's slam raised the tension level. But for these two teams, the best was yet to come.
50-50 with 8:30 remaining.
With the game tied, the battle was joined. At stake, nothing less than the national championship. With 20 ties and 18 lead changes, the teams would trade shot for shot. The one left standing would claim championship glory.
Moves in top of the key, fires it up, good for two. Kentucky goes back out on top for two. It is in the paint to Simon. Fires it up, four. 52-52, 15 ties in the game.
Mercer, quick jump off Patrick, shoots from 13 and scores another two.
Great basketball. Both teams starting to warm up now.
54-52, Kentucky with the lead.
Terry, three-point shot. Oh, what a big one. Puts Arizona ahead, 55-54.
These teams just went at each other's throats all night.
5.5 minutes left, 59-56, Arizona with the lead.
Hatchett ties it. He's really becoming the player here to keep Kentucky in it.
It was like a boxing match.
G.G. over to Mike Bibby. He spots up for a three.
Yeah! What a big three, a huge turnaround right there.
62-59, Wildcats under 5 minutes to go in the game.
Every time somebody did something, the other team answered.
Padgett looking for the tie. Oh, Scott Padgett, please.
You're not going to get us out of this thing.
62-all, 4:30 to go.
Down low, Davison, shot blocked. Davison gets it back, lay it up and in.
Great second effort, by a foul.
Arizona, the 65-62 advantage.
We're going back and forth.
67-64, Arizona, 2.5 minutes left. Fans rising to their feet here at the RCA Dome.
Turner off the dribble, switches around the left side. Bibby stays right with him. He drives, pulls up, five-footer, good. Kentucky's to the run.
Everyone had an answer for everything.
Another one coming from Scott Patrick. The shot is up, it is good. Kentucky by one.
Miles made big plays for us.
2 minutes remaining. The young Arizona Wildcats down one.
Come on!
Simon in the lane. Puts it back in front.
You can watch these teams play for days. You know, they just are so evenly matched.
As the game wound down to the final moments of regulation, it appeared Arizona had the upper hand, but Kentucky would not quit.
Second free throw for Mike Bibby. That is good. It's a four-point Wildcat lead, 72-68. 1 minute left as Kentucky brings the ball down court.
It looked like we had them buried. I was, you know, starting to feel a little bit comfortable, and bang, Mercer hits a three.
Here he comes. Mercer three. Got it!
Down the one. Indy Scribable from Indianapolis. Now drives in, dishes. Davison backs it home.
And Epps just hits that, you know, three to tie it up.
Kentucky needs a three to tie. Epps fires it.
Simon and Bibby now. They try to attack the press.
Simon drives. Simon shoots. No call.
deflated, Arizona could only wonder about missed opportunities and the possibility of championship dreams postponed or lost. Kentucky had new life and an eye toward overtime.
A lot of times when you're ahead, the other team comes back to tie the thing, send it into overtime. A lot of times that'll deflate the balloon, and the momentum is with the other team. And that's the whole thing that we talked about in the timeout. You can quit now. You know, you've played a great game. Or we can be tougher than what they are and come home with that championship trophy.
One last time, Lute Olson asked his players to reach down inside and find a single ounce more determination than the opposition. Tonight, it meant hitting free throws, as all of Arizona's 10 points in overtime came from the line. The Young Cats had responded to their coach's challenge. With the championship dream of a lifetime within reach, Miles Simon could feel the emotion of the moment.
Chills ran through my body. Just can't believe that we're about to win a championship.
It's only right. The ball's in his hands. A milestone victory for Arizona.
Simon says championship.
Arizona 84, Kentucky 79. The final score. The 1997 national champions, your Arizona Wildcats.
Winning national championship, best thing I've ever done or accomplished. And I'm just thankful that I have just great teammates and great coaches.
To win it for Coach Olson and to win it with this group of guys and the type of attitude that we've had throughout the tournament, it's just a great feeling. Nobody really gave us a chance to win any of these games, from the first game to Kansas to, you know, this one. And we just believed in our hearts that we could win the game, and, you know, if we played the way that we could play, then, you know, nobody could beat us.
It's winning the national championship for all of the guys that have played at Arizona. I mean, we have been so blessed with unbelievable young men. Arizona basketball has always been a family. It's young people who care about one another. I told the guys, thank you.
Coach Lute Olson and his Arizona Cool Cats had claimed their first ever national championship. A treasure to be shared with the entire Wildcat family throughout the ages.
It's the greatest feeling that I've ever had in my whole life, and I'm just going to try to come back next year.